Four River Shipyard in Quincy. During World War II, it was home to some of the most technologically advanced shipbuilding in the world. The mothballed USS Salem is a reminder of that past. Now, seven decades later, a new type of shipbuilding is pushing the technology boundaries again.
This is a very historic place in many ways, isn't it?
Absolutely. And as General Dynamics, we're really excited to be back. General Dynamics was here for a long time building ships here in the Four River Shipyard. And now we're back building robots for undersea.
It's known as an autonomous underwater vehicle, or AUV, a mini sub that's like an underwater drone. Bluefin Robotics began at MIT in 1997 and was purchased by General Dynamics in 2016.
And here in Quincy, we build everything from the smallest subassembly to the tail cone subassembly to the entire robot.
The middle section houses communication, electronics, and batteries.
This one will swim for about 24 hours before we need to recharge the batteries.
The nose can be outfitted with over 70 different sensors to unlock the secrets of the deep.
What we're looking at here is imagery of the seafloor that was actually collected by the underwater robot's eye.
This is amazing detail that you're getting, isn't it?
Yes, we get very high resolution because of the sensors that we're using.
They can map underwater facilities, even sunken ships. The UAVs come in a variety of sizes. This one, big enough to fit inside the torpedo tube of a submarine, and also carry smaller sand sharks.
It could swim for about a day, go where it needs to do, and deliver, like a bus, smaller robots. And each one of these smaller robots could have a different mission.
The Bluefin Sand Shark is so easily transported that you can actually carry it down to the water and launch it right off the dock.
The 11-pound Sand Shark will fit in a backpack and cost about $30,000. In 2014, a GD UAV was used in the search for Malaysian Airline Flight 307 in the Indian Ocean. It's able to descend more than 3 miles down to the ocean floor.
What we're doing here is really searching for the last frontier here on Earth and being able to go places where we've never been before. And so the possibilities are endless on what we can do and see now that we have robots that can take us there.
Wow. And Ed, you'll like this part. Yeah. You know, the small sand sharks are currently being used by climate researchers, harbor security, insurance companies looking for sunken boats.
Sure.
The other group, treasure hunters looking for pirates'
gold. Seriously?
Yes.
Yeah. You carried one. How much does it weigh?
About 11 pounds.
It wasn't
very light, and depending on what sensors you put in the front of it, you can do all kinds. You can put a GoPro camera on the front of it.
The applications are limitless.
They really are. I mean, and think they're about 10 years behind where the drones were. Drones are now fairly common. In 10 years, I bet you see more and more of these.